how are you doing sitting at home in the lockdown? I think a lot of us are doing first time things while we are stuck at home, and I'm doing a first time thing today. So I decided to make a video, and if everything goes well and if things come out good, then I will share it with all my friends. So what is it that I'm doing? I'm making karela ka sabzi. Yeah, some of you may just switch off the video right there, but for those of you who continue to listen and watch, and if you like karela, then yeah, it's a very simple sabzi, we all make it. But I'm making it different this time today because a friend has suggested this recipe, and he said that it comes out really, really great like this. So I decided to give it a go and make a video while I do it. We are all becoming cooking experts while we are in the lockdown. So, you know, here I go. And obviously, have a glass of wine to enjoy that time while we cook. I'm on to the last bottle of wine that I have. I don't know what I'm going to do after this. Hopefully the lockdown ends. But if not, God knows. Alright, so let's get started. So, here's some karela that I've cut like this, round. And some finely chopped onions. That's too much onion. I'm gonna not use all of it, but just a little bit of it. And a pan, which is microwave safe. Ideally a glass pan. You don't want a plastic pan because it's gonna be cooked for a good 15 to 20 minutes. So I just, while I was talking to you, I just added a tiny bit of oil to it. I think I need a little more. So about, say, a teaspoon and a half is what I have here. Now the first thing that happens is this goes in the microwave for about 2 minutes, as my friend tells me, to heat up the oil, right? And while that is happening, I'm gonna get my mustard seed out because that's what we need to pop in there after 2 minutes. Alright, so that's my spice box, masala dummy, and this is done, we don't need oil anymore, so still a minute and a half left. What else can I do in this time? I guess I can make my salad. Sorry, while you're watching and while the oil is heating, I'm going to just cut some cucumbers. I already have some pomegranate in my fridge, so that's going to be my simple salad today. Along with the karela, if it comes out well, otherwise salad is all I got. I'm just gonna check my oil. I think it's hot enough, but after about a minute and a half, so I'm gonna put like just that much, like half a teaspoon of mustard seed in there and let it crackle. I don't remember if he told me how much time we need to let the mustard seed crackle, but I'm trying 1.5 minutes. Let's see what happens. So I am just stirring my cucumbers in the meantime. And I've got some nice music going on in the background. Alright, that's done. So for the later on when we add masalas to our karela, the masalas that we need is like slight bit of turmeric powder if you want, but I skip turmeric powder a lot of times in my vegetables because I feel everything looks yellow and the same if I add turmeric powder to everything. So, but I will add chili a little bit, and so it's like just a pinch of turmeric powder. Depending on how spicy you want, chili powder, salt, of course, and some coriander powder and some cumin powder. That's pretty much all we need. if you want a bit of tanginess to it, you can add some nardana powder if you have, or you can add some amchur powder, mango powder, raw mango powder, whatever that is called. So that's all that we need in terms of masalas. Let's check our oil with mustard seeds. Okay, I need my mittens to get it out. Yeah, okay, so that worked. I think after a minute and a half of the mustard crackling, we are ready to go. Alright, so the next step is to add the karela to it, how much ever you want. So like 1.5, these are 3 karelas that is chopped here. And I put like a tablespoon and a half of oil. So I think I'm gonna let all of that go, because then it can last me for a couple of days and I will not have to cook again. Assuming it comes out well, which I hope it will, because my friend who suggested this, he's actually a good cook, I think. I'm trying to recall if he's ever cooked anything for me. But, can't recall anything. I'm trying to think, why do I have this impression that he's a good cook? I have no idea. Maybe he talks a lot about it. Next thing I'm doing is getting invited when the lockdown opens for a dinner at his place. That's what I need to do. And then, okay, so I'm adding about 1/2 cup of onions to it. I actually like a lot of onions in my karela. I pretty much add, when I make it the normal way, I pretty much add as much onion as the karela, or sometimes even more, because the onions give your karela a nice, sweetish touch, so it balances the bitterness of the karela. Karela, by the way, is bitter gourd, for those of you who do not understand what karela is. So the English term is bitter gourd. Bitter gourd? I don't know what it's called. Or rather how it's pronounced. Okay, so I added the karela and the onion to it. And then we're gonna add some salt. We're not adding all the salt that we want in this, but just a tiny bit right now, because that will help the bitterness of karela to go away, hopefully. Well, eventually in this recipe, the karela might still have that little bit of, aftertaste of a bitterness, which I actually enjoy. But if you don't enjoy that, I'm gonna tell you what you can do. But let me just pop this in the microwave first. Yeah, so we added karela, a little bit of onion, and some salt. And this is going back in for 6 minutes straight. Okay, so it has to cook for 6 minutes before we get to the next step. But while it's cooking for 6 minutes, we have to sort of stir it in between. So I think you can stir it 3 times or 2 times. So I'm gonna open it when it's about 3 minutes, because I want to let the heat be locked in and let it cook nicely. So in 3 minutes, I will open and then stir it once before we go on. Okay, so I was telling you about how to get the bitterness of karela out if you don't like it bitter, right? So when you, like how it was sitting here, just chopped, well, cut into rounds. You can add, for that much karela, you can add about a teaspoon of salt in it, and then just like mix the salt in the karela and let it sit. Let it sit for 1/2 hour to 1 hour minimum, and it would get a little mushy after that. And then you can just like sort of not like squeeze, but just like squeeze a little bit, or put it in like a little pan and squeeze it a little. So whatever juice comes out, let that go. There's a lot of nutrition in that, but if you let that go, that takes away most of the bitterness of the vegetable, right? So whatever bitterness a karela contributes to the end result, most of that would go if you do that little step before any of this. Yeah? So yeah, try it, depending on how you like it. Okay, I don't need onions anymore, go in the fridge. And I'm taking out my pomegranate to mix in my salad in the meantime. Just 2 teaspoons because I don't want my salad to be very sweet with pomegranates. Alright, and this is not a part of the video, but while we're at it, just gonna add a little bit of salt to my salad. A little bit of rock salt. Okay, there you go. And a little honey. All right. And a tiny bit of olive oil. I generally have a ready dressing. I make it at home with all these things and just pop it in my salad whenever I make salads. But I don't have that right now. So I'm just doing the random dressing recipe. And I need a little bit of vinegar in this recipe or in this dressing, but I'm out of vinegar. So I think I'm gonna add a tiny bit of lemon. Actually, with vinegar also you add lemon. So I'm just gonna add lemon right now. Sometimes if you want it nice and tangy, you can squeeze a bit of orange in your salad and that gives it a nice, you know, tangy but sweet touch. It's very nice and healthy. Okay, we're more than 3 minutes. I need to stir. While that is about to be done, I'm gonna get my mustard oil because I'm gonna add some mustard oil to the karela. So let me get that. Oh, all right, that's my mustard oil. Where's my wine? Right here. Okay. Just pan. I like to keep cleaning my kitchen while I'm cooking because otherwise I find it very stressful when there's too many things around and too much cleaning to do. Alright, done with the knife. This is something we need for stirring. We still need our spice box, so it's right here. I have too much stuff lying around. Need to get rid of all of that. Okay, we're set. Still about 50 seconds to go. So, how's life with you all in the lockdown? If you have something interesting, please do make a video and share. I don't know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but the amount of content I've watched on WhatsApp, videos, etc., some random content, some personalized videos that people are making just like what I'm doing right now. I'm doing it for the first time and I'm actually enjoying the process right now. Let's see how the video comes out. I don't even know if I'm in the range, if my face is seen in the video, because I'm making the video from not the selfie camera, but the normal camera. So I don't know what's the range, and we'll see. Alright, so the karela is done for the first 6 minutes. Let's pull it out. Okay, here we are. This is how it looks right now. Can you see?
I hope it's in the range.
Sort of partially cooked. Now, okay, this is a step which my friend's recipe does not have, but I added it because I generally do this when I'm pan cooking as well, and I love the taste of mustard oil in some of my vegetables, like karela, bhindi, sometimes cauliflower, but mainly karela and bhindi. Try it next time if you've never tried it. It's amazing. It gives your vegetables a nice achari taste, like a pickle-like taste, which I think is very nice. Okay, so what I did was I added about a teaspoon of mustard oil, and now I need to add all the masalas. So I'm adding just a tiny bit of turmeric, like we said earlier. And I have a different spoon for my turmeric because I hate my salt to start looking yellow when the same spoon goes in all the other spices. Oops, damn, I think I added a little too much chili powder than I normally like in my vegetables. But it's okay, we'll see. My chili powder thankfully is not very spicy. I don't eat spicy food, so obviously you please add according to your taste. But this ideally is supposed to come out like a crispy karela, which I'm not sure, you know, because it's sort of watery right now. But we'll see. I'm trusting my friend on this. And then I'm adding, so remember this was about 3 normal size karelas. And I'm adding about a teaspoon of coriander powder to this. And about half a teaspoon of cumin powder to this. And alright, so we have to add a little more salt. I'm very bad at how much salt generally goes in the veggies. So I keep tasting it in between. Right now I can't taste because it's very raw. But I've added just tiny bit more salt. We're gonna stir it a bit. Give it, actually not a bit, but give it a nice mix. And make sure, make sure that the karela gets, all of the karela gets coated nicely with the I can smell that mustard oil. It's amazing. It's almost like as if you opened a nice bottle of fresh pickle, and I love that. Love that. Alright, so we're stirring that. We're just making sure all of the karela is coated with the spices. And I wonder if I can try some of it for the salt. This is gonna be bitter and raw, but I'm gonna try. I can eat bitter stuff. I can eat the vegetables I like. I can just eat them raw. Well, not raw, but half raw. So I think I will need just a little more salt in this. Okay, it should be good, and I can always add in the third round. So we're gonna, after the spices, I think I'm gonna add just a tiny bit more coriander powder. And coriander powder and cumin powder is something you can adjust to your liking, right? Some people like a lot of masala on their vegetables. I like my vegetables to show. Like, I don't like too much masala on my vegetables. I almost like them like salad-ish, if I can say so. So yeah, you can always adjust masalas based on how you pan cook them. Alright, so I've stirred it nicely. A nice aroma of mustard oil hitting my nose. I love it. And I think I'm gonna love my wine after that a lot more. Not a good combination, mustard oil and wine, but who cares? I like it. Okay. So going in the microwave after putting all the masalas for another 6 minutes. And again after about 3 minutes, we're gonna stir it. And because it's 6 minutes, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna switch off this video, start again after 6 minutes, and in that way I'm gonna also check my video if I'm in the range, if you guys can see me. Well, as long as you can hear me and see the vegetables, it's good. But I will restart because 6 minutes is a long time, I think, and the video is going to be very, very long to post anywhere. So let me stop and then I will reconnect. All right.